Hi, I'm Adrien from FabDam Moscow, and today we're going to make a mechanical system. It can be anything which different parts who moves together. So, I don't know, a toy, a clamp, a lamp, any idea you have. As an example, I made this letter scale. So basically, it's a scale for a really light object, typically less than 100 grams. The first step is to find an idea, but how to find an idea? It can be from your own interest. For me, it works a lot like that. It can be one of your needs. I don't know, you need a chair, something for your own apartment. So it's a really good starting point. If you really don't have idea, I suggest you to see the website Instructables. And on this website, you have like thousands of ideas. So just pick one and make your own version. So once you have an idea, I suggest you to start with a pen and a piece of paper. The first reflex is sometimes to go directly on your CAD system and start modeling. But I think it's not a good idea because you are not really free and you don't have a really good idea of what you want. When you're drawing something, you can start drawing different views and different details of the assembly. So then when you are modeling on the computer, it will be much clearer in your mind. So now I'm going to make some calculation because I'm interested to know for which weight, which angle will have my scale. For any project, it's a good idea to really think where are the forces and how it works, basically. And calculation is also a good solution. So in my situation, when I put something, you see the angle changing, and this is what we're gonna calculate now. Okay, so now how can we modelize the scale? So there is two arms and two masses, basically. A big one and a small one. And on this side, I have I will call the big length and the small length. We know the angle between these two arms, which is 135 degrees. And we have the angle, the moving angle, which I will call it alpha. Now, let's start with the Newton equation. So basically, the torque on the left should be equal to the torque on the right side in order to have the balance. And so now I have the mathematical equation, but we don't exactly know how this function looks like. Of course, you can use analysis and try to find, but the easier way is just to evaluate this function at different points with Octave. So let's go to Octave. Just now we found the relationship between the different parameters like the length, the weight, and the angle. But I don't really know how this function looks like. With Octave, which is a free program, we're gonna make a graph of this function. Okay, so here we are in Octave. And the first thing is to create this variable, which is an array, where I enter all the different, each 10 grams up to 170s. And then the small length is 20 millimeter. After that, I have the big mass, which is 32.5 grams, and also the big length, which is 80 millimeter. After that, we need to enter the formula that we just found. So it's arctangent. D is for degrees, so it's the small mass times the length. Here I use the small dot to say that it's just a multiplication, not a matrix multiplication. Square root of 2 times the big mass times the big length minus m. Here the dot is not required, but I put it anyway, times the small length. And now the last thing we have to do is to actually make the graph, which is done by the command plot. I just give the first array, the mass array on the x-axis, and the y-axis is the result of the angle. So I just save it and then run the script. And everything, if everything works, we see the graphs. So we can see that it's not perfectly aligned, which is obvious with the formula we had. If you want to have some points instead of a line, I just this command with O, and here is the result. If you want the grid, you can use the option grid on. I run it again, and here is the result. So now I can see for each 10 grams which angle will have the scale. And here I can see the vector with all the computed angles. These numbers are used after in the design to draw the scale. And I will enter all these numbers at the right place. Here I show you how I made the scale. The scale is not cut, but engraved. This is why it's another file. I draw all the slots, and for each slot there is this dotted line, and I manually entered all the angles that we calculated with Octave. Here with this function, we can see how I drew the numbers. I just basically use draw along the curve and enter the numbers. So in order to cut the part, we need to extract it in the DXF format, which is the format taken by the laser cutting. So I just save as a DXF, as we can see, and put the name and validate. Here's the result. So now we are going to cut all the parts. Okay, so now we have all the parts. And to assemble this scale, I use these paper clips, some glue, and these big bolts is just for the counterweight. I found out that the M10 times 15 length and with the bolts is almost perfectly 30 grams. So this is what we want. And these two are for the scale, but you can also just glue it up. And I also use these pliers to cut the paper clips. And so let's do that. Don't be afraid if your project never works like for the first time, like expected for the first time. It's really normal to go back to the design phase and improve it and go back to prototyping and make some iteration like this. Okay, now I finished the assembly. I will write an article on Instructables, so I hope I inspired you to make something and also share with us, with the world on the social networks, and see you next time.